Welcome to another practice video. I remember when I was a piano teacher in a previous life, and people would come to me and they say, I want to know how to be a great piano player. I say, sure, okay. Well, first thing you got to do is you got to practice. They said, okay, I got it. And then I said, you need to practice some more. And they said, okay, I got it. And then you need to practice the basics even more. I said, okay. You got to be really disciplined. All right, I got that. You have to really want it. Really want it. Okay, yeah, I want it, okay. Anything else? I said, okay. Be very musical. Play beautiful songs, beautiful music people want to hear. They said, all right, thank you. Thank you very much. Now I know how to be a great piano player. Bye. Huh? How about a lesson? You want? No. I understood everything you said. So they'd go on to someone else, and they said, hey, you know, I'm a great piano player. I mean, I know how to be a great piano player. And they shared, yeah, discipline, practice the basics, practice some more, play great music, be disciplined, et cetera. And they said, wow, yeah. Okay, that's how you be a great piano player. Yes. So the word kept, then they started telling people. Before you know it, all these people, they knew how to be great piano players. So they had a convention of all these great piano players. People really knew how to be great piano players. And I went to the convention, and I decided to, you know, play a song there on the piano. And everyone stopped. Listen and say, what are you doing? And I said, well, I'm kind of, you know, demonstrating, you know, how to play, be a great piano player. That's what the convention's about, right? And I said, wait a minute. What's this all about anyway? What are you, crazy? What are you doing? You're interrupting, you're interfering with our convention here. We're talking about how to be a great piano player. So, you know, we can't even talk with you playing that piano like that. Get out of here. So, that's how it goes. What we do here is we actually practice. If you want to be enlightened, you have to actually practice. You have to practice realizing that you don't need to practice. You have to give a lot of time to accepting that you don't need any time. That's just the name of the game. That's the way it is, because we have believed for so long that time is the answer. If we just give ourselves enough time, we'll learn to love death. So when I say we don't need any time at all, we say, well, how do we manage then? I don't think I'm going to succeed, you know? Well, you're going to succeed in realizing you don't need any time with the help of the Holy Spirit. So, what we're going to practice here is called God's justice. And God's justice on us is actually to give us this great last laugh. That's the justice. God says, you know what, you're going to laugh. My justice for you is you're going to laugh about how silly your prank was. That's my justice for you. You're going to have a good laugh. So we actually have to get ready for this laugh, to laugh like this, to experience this, and here we go with the practicing, to experience this bright, divine, unlimited relief. Okay, bright, divine, unlimited relief. I'm ready to experience this clean, transcendent, unconstricted laughter. Clean, transcendent, unconstricted laughter. I am ready to experience this fresh, grand, unconditional assurance. I'm ready to experience this exquisite, holy, sheer reconciliation. this exquisite, holy, sheer reconciliation. I am ready to experience this ineffable, sacred, complete forgiveness. This ineffable, sacred, complete forgiveness. I am ready for that. I am ready to experience this majestic, lofty, full-dress joke. I am ready to experience this ethereal, splendiferous, organic denouement. I am ready to experience this perfect, pure, unreduced ending. Perfect, pure, unreduced ending. I am ready to experience this splendid, natural, unitary wrap-up. Wrapping it up. I am ready to experience this superb, complete, unbroken conclusion. Superb, complete, unbroken conclusion. I am ready to experience this flawless, lucid, faultless justice. Flawless, lucid, faultless justice. Yes. I am ready to experience this incomparable, unalloyed, blameless judgment. Wow. Blameless judgment. I am ready for that experience. I am ready to experience this superlative, unclouded, spotless resolution. It's all resolved. What a resolution. I am ready for that. I am ready for to experience this precious, immaculate, stainless last act. The final act. I'm ready for that. I am ready to experience this matchless, supreme, unblemished final curtain. The final curtain. I am ready for that. I am ready to experience this wonderful, beautiful crowning culmination. I am ready to experience this sublime, lovely, marvelous comfort. What a comfort it is. God's justice. What a comfort it is. I am ready to experience this exalted, godly, august release. Release from all concern. What a great justice God's justice is. I am ready to experience this delicate, regal, glorious pacifier. I am truly pacified. Okay, so just soak that in for a moment here. This is God's justice that we are preparing to experience. We're preparing to experience this. So we want to get a feel of how is that going to feel? How is it going to feel? It's going to feel absolutely wonderful. That is for sure. And these are just practices that we're using to get ready for that, to experience it actually. Okay. This just kind of helps us realize that, you know what, we can probably do it. We can probably do it. If we can talk about it like this, we can probably do it. Okay. I am ready to experience the peaceful, visionary presence of happiness. That is God's justice. I am ready to experience the blissful, free, beautiful deliverance of God's justice. I am ready to experience the oneness, the loveliness, the everywhereness of the easement of God's justice. I'm ready to experience the forgiving purity and nowness of solace. That is God's justice. I am ready to experience the glorious, spacious, eternal palliative that God's justice is. I am ready to experience the serene, silent, timeless consolation. A serene, silent, timeless consolation. I am ready to experience the calm, still, formless, load off my mind. The still, the calm, still, formless load off my mind of God's justice. I am willing, I am ready to experience the inclusive, boundless, sweet cure. The sweet cure of God's justice. I am willing, ready, and willing to experience the grateful, lightful, belonging extrication, the delightful extrication. I am ready to experience the grateful, I just said that, I am ready to experience the smooth, effortless, endless alleviation of God's justice. I am ready to experience the clear, seamless, incorruptible solution that is God's justice. I am ready and willing to experience the fresh, boundless, radiant remedy that is God's justice for us. I am ready to experience and abide in the heart of isness that is the recovery that God's justice provides for me. It is the recovery. It is the heart of recovery. I am ready to experience the eternal, centered remembrance of healing. I am ready and willing to experience the blessed assurance and compassion of the antidote, which is God's justice for us. I am ready and willing to experience the graceful, carefree, self-released countermeasure that God has provided for us in the form of the Holy Spirit. I am ready to experience the holy, visionary oneness of the great panacea that is God's justice. I'm ready for that. All right. So we will continue on here with this practice session. Take a little breather here. I am ready to and willing to experience the intrinsic, effulgent, non-concretized, restorative, that is God's justice. I am ready to experience, ready and willing to experience the traceless, equal, non-reified assistance that is God's justice, the assistance for me. I am ready to experience the identical, immutable, ultimate smoothed outness that is God's justice for me. I am ready to experience the baseless, coincident, total assuagement that is God's justice for me. I am ready and willing to experience the infallible, inseparable, groundless refreshment that is God's justice for me. I am ready and willing to experience the mindless, transparent, locationless soother that is God's justice for me. I am ready to experience the uncontrived, changeless, and formless rectification that is God's justice for me. I am ready to experience the natural, unalloyed, non-related turnaround, which is God's justice for me. I am ready and willing to experience the spaced out, all good, non-localized reclamation that is God's justice for me. I am ready and I am willing to experience the undifferentiated, supreme, non-other improvement, which is God's justice for me. I am ready and willing to experience the all-pervasive, authentic, as-it-is cleanup, that is God's justice for me. I am ready and willing to experience the non-congealing, unborn, residue-free change, which is God's justice for me. I am ready and willing to experience the core, non-fixated, non-defined reformation, which is God's justice for me. I am ready and willing to experience the unceasing, ever-knowing, process-free repair, that is God's justice for me. I am ready and willing to experience the non-crystallizing one singular salve, that is God's justice for me. I am ready and willing to experience the wide open, dust-free, non-compounded prescription, which is God's justice for me. I am ready and willing to experience the unelaborated, all-embracing, non-fabricated abatement, which is God's justice for me. I am ready and willing to experience the immaculate, singular peace offering, which is God's justice for me. So we get our feet wet just a little bit here with some practicing. It's not so difficult. It's not so difficult. We're just tuning our psyche towards this incredible justice, the justice of we don't need to go through all that time. We don't need any more time. We don't need to waste any more time. The Holy Spirit shows us how time ends up, and it ends up in this wonderful, wonderful way. It ends up in this wonderful, wonderful way. It ends up as relief. It ends up as happiness. It ends up as a panacea. It ends up laughter. It is deliverance. It is restorative. It is assurance. It is easement. It is assistance. It is reconciliation. It is solace. It is assuagement. It is forgiveness. It is palliative. It is refreshment. It is a joke. It is consolation. It is a soother. It is a denouement. It is a load off our mind. It is a rectification. It is an ending. It is a cure. It is a turnaround. It is a wrap-up. It is an extrication. It is a reclamation. It is a conclusion. It is a balm. It is an improvement. It is justice. It is alleviation. It is cleanup. It is the final judgment. It is a fix. It is a change. It is a resolution. A resolution. It is a solution. It is a reformation. It is the last act. It is a remedy. It is a repair. It is a final curtain. It is a recovery, a salve, a culmination, a healing, a prescription, a comfort, an antidote, an abatement, a release, a countermeasure, a pacifier, and a peace offering. All brought to us by the Holy Spirit in His capacity to already be aware of the end of time and be able to show us that ending of time right now. And we see that everybody, no matter how wicked they may seem at this point in time, the Holy Spirit shows how they ended up they ended up absolutely, totally getting it, that this was all just a joke. And they really realize the perfection that they are, that everything is, that they realize the perfection of everything. They were willing to drop this prank on themselves. Everything ends up that way. And the Holy Spirit's able to show that to us right now. This is the totally cool relief that is available for us right now. It is the remedy that's available to us right now, as it is, without anything needing to change at all, right? Because Holy Spirit already knows through all the changes in all of time, it all winds down to this acceptance that, yeah, we were just pranking ourselves, that's all. We didn't need to do any of this. It's all totally unnecessary. That's how it winds down. Getting ready to experience this great relief, this great relief. This great forgiveness, this great laughter, this great assurance. All is well, all is well, all is well, all is well. Okay, and these practices, so far, they've been extremely helpful for me because they bypass the intellect and they go to the level of acceptance, but really practicing acceptance. And of course, our intellect says, I don't get it, I don't get it, I'm not really sure, what. Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what the intellect gets or doesn't get. It's only matters what we accept. It's the only thing that matters is what do we accept. And then the intellect will chew on that. The intellect's just chewing on whatever we've accepted. That's all it's doing. So, accept this great relief, this great happiness, this great panacea, this great restorative, this great deliverance, this great laughter, this great assurance, this great easement, this great assistance, this great assuagement, this great solace, this great reconciliation, this great forgiveness, this great palliative, this great refreshment, this great soother, this great consolation, this great joke, this great denouement, this great load off our mind, this great rectification, this great turnaround, this great cure, this great ending, this great wrap-up, this great extrication, this great reclamation, this great improvement, this great balm, this great conclusion, this great justice, this great alleviation, this great cleanup, this great change, this great fix, this great judgment, this great resolution, this great solution, this great reformation, this great repair, this great remedy, this great last act, this great final curtain, this great recovery, this great salve, this great prescription, this great healing, this great culmination, this great comfort, this great antidote, this great abatement, this great peace offering, this great countermeasure, this great pacifier, this great release. Release, release from all concern. All concern, this great release from all fear, all types of concern. This unbounded release from concern. We are no longer concerned about anyone or anything ever again. We're totally assured of their salvation, of everyone's salvation, total assurance, because we're aware of it. The Holy Spirit's showing it to us. This is the great remedy that Jesus has given us, that's told us about, and says, this is what it is. This is it. And you see, our intellect has been chewing on a bone for so long of what we've accepted that we've got to learn how to learn death, learn how to love death. And the intellect is chewing on that, saying, just keeps chewing on it. We have to accept God's final judgment on all, on our prank, on pranking ourselves. What is God's final judgment upon that? And lo and behold, it is this wonderful release and relief and assuagement and assurance and laughter and joke and realization. It's all been just us joking ourselves. That's it. And God did not forget to laugh about this. See, God has kept our laughter for us because we forgot to laugh. But God has not forgotten us and not forgotten our laughter and God's laughter, and has that laughter waiting for us so that we can finally laugh it away. Then that's it. Okay, very great. That's it for this practice video.